One. Hello everybody, it's the Historical Gamer once again, and today I'm joined by Tortuga Power. How are you doing today, Tortuga?
I'm doing excellent. I'm ready to drop some nukes.
The other night you were telling me this is what you've dreamt about your entire life.
My childhood dream. I always dreamt of thermonuclear war.
All right, well, today we're going to get a chance to do that. We're playing ICBM, a new game by Slitherine, folks over at Slitherine. This is basically a modern recreation, well, not that it's that old, but a newer recreation and maybe a more detailed recreation of a game called DEFCON. And in this game, in ICBM, basically the goal is to wipe out the opposing countries or continents or what have you in a rain of nuclear hellfire.
That's right. And you just score a bunch of points by killing all the populations. I guess the goal is to kill more of the enemy population than you lose yourself by some scoring mechanism. We're gonna have a pretty hard time because we're going 2v4, hoping that maybe that will lead to a balanced game against four AI opponents.
Well, when I was playing the AI in a sort of a free for all, every country for itself, there were 8 players, me and 7 AIs, and I lost pretty badly. So I take that for what it is.
But you took that beating, and then you thought about it, and you're coming back twice as strong. And plus, we're using destroyers this time, so.
Well, and I'm America. Well, I guess I'm North America, so you know, can't beat me now, right?
Well, yeah, I mean, yeah, that's true. And I'm Europe, so I'm your buddy to the east. I don't have any problems. It's not that I'm surrounded by both Russia and the Middle East. No problems.
Yeah, Europe feels like one of the most vulnerable starting continents, if you will. But this game, by the way, what you were talking about, you know, hopefully you get fewer of your people killed than you kill of the enemy, reminds me of, what's his name? The general in Doctor Strangelove, where he's trying to sell the president on going to war, and he's basically like, I'm not telling you that we won't get our hair mussed, but I am telling you no more than 20 to 30 million dead and then on the break.
Yeah. So, I was thinking about talking about the point distributions. I still have my default loaded up, but we've gone back and forth quite a few times on different potential starting strategies, and I think this is one of the first most interesting things about the game is you can kind of beeline towards something in the very beginning if you choose to redistribute your points. And we've kind of talked about that might be the ideal thing to do, is put yourself as far down one path as you can, go with a strategy, and just go all in. At least that's what I'm planning to do. So do you want to talk through yours first? Do you want me to do mine?
Yeah, I'll go first. I'm not sure I'm going to go down one and go all in, but I am going to heavily focus on Sam's sort of for a defensive strategy initially. So I have basically wiped out my air bases. I've gotten rid of the carriers, the submarines, some of the radars. And my initial distribution is going to have me building 4 destroyers. The main thought behind that is going Navy heavy for North America makes sense to me. We have South America and Africa turned off. And all of our other opponents are you know, in either Asia or I guess the Pacific, right? Since you're on Europe and you're my ally. So my thought process is I need a good sea-based defense to defend my West Coast from the Pacific region as well as from Asia. And then I need good radars and SAMs to defend from over-the-top missile attacks coming over the poles. So I'm going to use destroyers to do that. To support my destroyers, I am also going to research some technologies. I'm researching SAMs, because without SAMs, your destroyers can't shoot down enemy aircraft or missiles. And I'm also researching cruise missiles. My thought process is the cruise missiles will let me outrange any enemy ships and allow me to pick off the enemy naval forces that start the game before they have time to research that technology, while the SAMs will help me shoot down any incoming planes from enemy carriers that we might engage since I got rid of my own carrier. Additionally, I am researching improved long wave radar technology. It doesn't give me better engagement ranges with my SAMs, but it does give me better visibility so I can hopefully quickly detect where the enemy warships are and hunt them down. And my plan is to launch a preemptive strike on the enemy navies in the Pacific and in Asia and try and wipe them out before they have a chance to build up to a point where they can threaten me and I'll be able to outrange them with my cruise missiles.
Yeah.
I'm also building 2 megaton bombs and 2 nuclear bombs, basically just to use up my points. And then I am building a radar site and a SAM site, since, again, I have some leftover points. And I figured I'd put a SAM somewhere and start to build a net of SAMs across my northern borders.
Yeah, might as well take advantage of the destroyer meta before it's patched out, right? So I'm doing the same thing. I'm going to be really trying to invest in destroyers and take out the naval threats right away. And your destroyers are pretty good at it, going and harassing even land emplacements, which are close enough to the sea. So I am also going to get rid of my... I'm going to get rid of my carrier, my submarine, two of my radars. I don't know how many bombs I'm supposed to get rid of, but I'm also going to take the cruise missiles. And then I'm going to take... actually, I'm going to take maneuvering missiles. So I'm just going all in on my destroyers, which means I'll grab another destroyer and another destroyer. And I have 7 points remaining, so we'll get... Oh, 3 megaton bombs, another nuke. So that leaves me with 1 airbase, 5 destroyers, 1 radar, 9 nukes, and 3 megaton bombs, plus the 2 cruise missiles. So the big disadvantage is I'm not going to have... my destroyers won't have the ability to shoot down enemy aircraft. And as I've already discovered, this is... I mean, maybe it's a little stupid. I don't know if you're laughing at me, THG, but... Because I just did this, and it didn't work out because all my destroyers were destroyed by aircraft. But I think I can make it work this time. We'll see.
Oh, I mean, we'll just have to make sure to invest in the SAMs somewhat early on.
Yeah, right away.
Hopefully prevent you from losing a bunch of investment. I'm going a little more balanced. I think you're going a little bit more offensive focus. I will say destroyers are an interesting choice with you playing as Europe, because you've got land borders and a lot of... You know, most of the missiles are going to come at you from over the land, not over the water. So I'm curious to see how it plays out for you. I hope you survive. We're on the same team, so...
That's right. You're rooting for me. But if nothing else, I mean, if things start going to hell over here, at least you can hope that they'll focus on me instead of you. Just let all of Europe die so that America lives.
You know, yeah.
Your words, not mine, right? You said it, not me.
Yeah, I'm sure some countries in Europe felt that way during the Cold War, so that seems historically accurate.
Okay, I'll rile up my base.
With that being said, we are going to jump in here in a second. We're not going to have shared audio while we play the game, so we're kind of giving you this intro together, but as we jump in, we're going to sort of end this audio call, and on my channel, you'll just hear me. On Tortuga's channel, you'll just hear him. You know, if you want to listen to Tortuga's side, make sure you're watching his channel's videos. If you're interested in listening to my side, obviously watch mine. Hey, watch them both, and you might see the same war from different perspectives. And we will keep in touch in the game's chat. So we'll have text communications that go back and forth, but that's where we're going to go.
Sounds good. All right, well, I'll catch you on the other side, then I'll start the load. Oh, wait, right. Not everyone's ready.
I'm ready now. Catch you on the flip side.
Okay, so we're now in the game without THG. He's off probably doing his own thing, preparing for, you know, whatever he needs to prepare for. And hopefully we'll be taking care of ourselves pretty well here. I'm expecting that Russia is going to come over the top here, so that's the first thing we're going to prep for, is a big old fight with them. Now, as far as research goes, I think SAMs have just got to be, like, 100% have to be the first thing. But we can also set up... You can shift-Q, I think, one thing. So I want to shift-Q advanced aircraft. Shift-click to add to Q, yeah. Let's add advanced aircraft. So that'll work. And then construction-wise, let's also slant a little bit towards science. And I think... Okay... I'm going to go with more destroyers right away, because I already invested a lot in them, and I think the best way to get a lot out of them is just to continue to produce them. And we're going live here in 5 seconds. Here we go. All right, so let's see if my plan worked, my great plan. Any destroyers, so their fleet is right here. We could try to engage them, but we're going to do that with our massive destroyer fleet. Now, I think Alt is to follow. Yeah, I think... So let me see. Yeah, the whole entire group is a big fleet. So I got my 5 destroyers going that way. We have no visibility over the Mediterranean. So as far as I'm concerned, or as far as anybody's concerned... Oh my god, look at the range we are firing. And that is because this radar has given us access to that information. So this is where I think destroyers are going to be amazing, because we have our maneuvering missiles, which are just going to pelt the hell out of these guys. Now, unfortunately, they have already seen us, and we don't have SAMs, so we have no means of shooting down these airplanes. Yikes. And we do have one means, and that is our own fighters. So we're just going to draw back here. Whoever's taking the most hits, by the way, is going to be the one I pull off the line. So far, so good. Oh, this guy took a hit. That's fine. So we already sank one of their destroyers. This is a good start. Let me tab alt click. Hopefully that helps him. Okay, how are we doing? I'm seeing a few hits, but one of the great things is once we're in our national borders, we get auto repaired. So this guy just needs to break formation, and probably we need all these guys to break. Did we just sink? I think we just sank. We sank almost everything. This is great. Very good start. Okay, so let's take a look at everything that's going on. Sam's gonna be another 9 minutes, even though we ramped up research a little bit. Not much we can do. We have predefined teams. That's how it's blue versus red. Otherwise, the AI, everyone could just be doing their own thing, dancing in and out. Did lose some fighters here. Looks like we're down to 3 out of 15. That is not good as far as losses go, but that's fine. So, alt, click. Now, if I click this guy and I double click him, yep, all 5 are in formation. Okay, well, here we go. Now, can you please move into friendly territory? I might have to go take this guy off. Is he the only one who's not healed? Yeah. Okay, so you're going to become my London defender. We're probably having a fleet going up from there. Did you get that? One ship to another. Right on time, another destroyer. And I'm expecting that this guy's going to have some issues around there. So what we really need is a radar. I know I was a little gung-ho. Whoops, not chat this. I was a little gung-ho about these destroyers, but let's get a... not a carrier. Yeah, we want radar so we can actually see what's going on. And this is so expensive to get an airbase, but we're going to need one. But again, our strategy in the very beginning is going to be focus on destroyers. Get in while the getting's good. And this destroyer almost completely healed now. That's great to see. Yeah, I think we're actually going to switch a little bit even heavier into science, because I really want those SAMs. Once we have those SAMs, I can probably roll back onto construction a little bit more. But for now, not so. And I don't know if it's useful, so basically what we'd like to do is hide around the corner. We really need our radar done before we can do much, but unit reached its destination. Okay, let's keep going. Let's push on over, see what we got in store for ourselves here. Or maybe that means it's already a good time to send this fleet back. Do I really need all 4 of these guys over here? Probably not. So many decisions. I love this game, by the way. I really think this is a great game. The control scheme is nice. Huh. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know how to help him then. Is there a shift click menu? No. I think shift click is just to set patrols. It's pretty cool. You can actually set up patrols and everything in this. So just grab my main guy here. We see here. I can do something like this. And if I reconnect the dots, we got a patrol. They're going to do that grid, patrol grid forever. We said until I tell them to stop. Okay, so let's also get all our aircraft replenished here. That'll happen after we do the one destroyer, one more radar, and then some more destroyers. Okay, yeah. And honestly, I think 3 destroyers is enough. So I'm going to move one more over here. Eventually, once we control the Mediterranean, I don't know if we can use the Suez Canal. We'll find out, because I'll move some forces over there. I definitely want to move into the Black Sea if I'm allowed. I also don't know if that's allowed, but we'll find out. Okay, so let me, I think I'll, we could bump it up. Yeah, okay, good. We bumped it up to level 2. We're in sync. A little exclamation mark saying that I don't have enough fighters there. Yeah, okay, so you can also left click the new ones right on. Who's coming over here? You. So you are gonna alt click on this guy as well. And now that guy has all three. Good. So those guys are set. We want them kind of parked over here. I'm gonna get a radar, plop it down so that I have better visibility over here. There's the radar. Perfect. And the cool thing is, this map is flat. If I hit M, I go to the globe mode, and this allows us to actually place, I mean, why doesn't it look like a circle? Why is it, you know, because we're not at the equator. At the equator, it would be a perfect circle, but, you know, there's that horizontal dilation as you get closer to the pole, because the same amount of, let's see, longitude, the same traversal in longitude should be a different distance when you're closer to the pole, if I have that correct. I don't think this radar really needs to do much. Really, all it has to do is see what's rounding the tip. Or do we want to actually have visibility over... Okay, we'll put this here. So far, so good. I like THG's support. Let me actually do this. Take off my headphones since we don't need the headphones anymore.
Research complete.
Research. Oh, perfect. Okay, so we want to set up a new research. And I probably need to go start getting advanced SAMs. Just seems so useful to me. Hypersonic missiles, even better. No, I want advanced aircraft. Oh, duh, we're already doing it. Stealth aircraft would be really good as well. I feel like maybe air. Okay, let's do that next. And then we also want to start building SAMs. A lot of SAMs. Lot. I think that the number of destroyers we have already might be sufficient. So we got 4. We're moving. Time to move out. Look at my destroyers. Just doing their patrols. I think that we're basically... we're not completely covering. There's a little spot up there that they could get through. Now, we don't need to patrol like this. This is just kind of a fun thing I set up. I'm going to actually send one destroyer all the way in here. So that guy's breaking off from the pack. He's going to go over and we're going to just patrol St. Petersburg in the Baltic. New destroyers ready. I mean, honestly, we're getting to the point where we have more destroyers than we really need. I guess I could take one destroyer off of here. I'll click him. So these guys now will just be my patrol. I could actually probably patrol something like this. There we go. Just do a little... I don't know if I want that triangle happening, but I just want to make sure I can see when people are coming into the... We can try to squeeze off and control the Atlantic. Destroyers being able to spot submarines. Hopefully that'll be helpful. Yeah, this looks good. I don't know what this green dot thing is doing. But, oh well. Not really sure. Has THG said anything? Oh, no. Okay, fighters being built. We got tons of SAMs incoming though. Why do we have more fighters? Huh. Okay, advanced aircraft will finish. Then we'll do this, advanced SAMs. And then we'll probably pour even more into destroyers. We'll get the hypersonic missiles. Eventually, at some point, we're going to need to get megaton bombs, nuclear bombs, I mean, more nuclear ordnance to drop. Actually, one of the things I also really want is another airbase. I really do want that. Because I think airbases are quite good. Weak, especially in Europe, we're going to be able to hit so many different things. Now, I need these destroyers to not be lazy, get going. I need them over here because I need, I basically need to, can we just attack a city? Well, let's move close enough and see what's there. I'm expecting at some point our radar is going to detect. What are you guys doing? Okay, so you... Yeah, got all three. Good. Submarine revealed somewhere. Oh, well, there's radar. West Asia. West Asian submarine. Where? Nowhere I can see. Probably this is a good point to switch back. There it is. Yeah, probably switch back to the flat map. It's not quite as cool, I think, but it's maybe a little bit more informative. Enemy SAM site. This is why he's there. This is why we're paying him the big money.
Research complete.
No, I want you to, no, I want you to be separate. I want you to detach. And you are gonna move here, and you're gonna alt guard him, and you're gonna alt guard him. There we go. No, don't. How do I detach him? Okay, there we go. He somehow got dropped. So now we can secure this area. This guy needs patrol orders. Let's make our patrol orders a little bit more aggressive. Eh, something like this. Basically just a circle over there. So I'm gonna leave those guys going. Okay, we've gotten here. Can we... Big question, can we get in here? No. Oh my gosh, we have SAMs ready to go. Okay, well, look it. I think we're gonna start putting SAMs right on the border. We mean you no harm. Athens is not gonna make it, I'm pretty sure. Sorry, Athens. Might as well evacuate now. Oh boy, okay. So we're gonna start our defenses. Start piling them up. And I might as well start putting them up here, since we have very good visibility. This area. Uh-oh. Well, I don't think that those are attacking from an airbase over there. Now, it's nice that we have SAMs. You can see how effective our destroyers are. Yeah, but one of our... Oh my god, two of our destroyers got just hammered. So, we'll have our SAMs here, which is going to be really helpful for deterring enemy fighters, even. How we doing? Plenty coming up. Tons of... lots of time left. Okay, so let's go to advanced SAMs. This is apparently set to go, so I'm going to shift-click to add this. Eventually, our destroyers are going to be like super destroyers. Alright, here we go again. And these SAMs, I think, are just going to be so helpful. Yeah, so we're just going to line the Russian border. And we have our one destroyer here, which should be able to help us out a great deal. I don't know where they went. We could actually pursue them all the way around, but... And that's what I'm paying them the big money for. Destroyer meta. I mean, it's obviously the AI is just not being that intelligent. Can we get any closer? If we can, one of the things I'm gonna need, honestly, is gonna be longer range radar. Because if we had longer range radar, we would know what else is there. Like, we're at the limit. Okay, well, we'll just kind of do a patrol over here. See what we can see. Yep, we're gonna have to go all the way around the map. Okay, first of all, it's good to know, right? It's good to know that this is not passable. The Panama Canal is not passable for us either, so it's not too surprising. What it means is we're only gonna have to patrol in here when we think West Asia might be putting units over there. Otherwise, we can... I actually want to redo this patrol. Let's have these guys really cover. I just want to make sure that we really cover this area for ASW. Enemy SAM destroyed. Very good. So the SAMs are going in. Maybe we can take a look at what THG's doing. So he's getting some radar stations up. He has space radar already, which is good, because eventually you'll want over the horizon radar, and you need that. You need to research space radar to get there. It's not going to be our priority number one, but our priority number one is going to be, God knows how we'll do it, but we'll try to protect even like the eastern, like the Ukrainian. Hey, Minx, that's not been in the news at all lately, has it? For those of you watching this, who's going to watch this very much in the future? I don't know if you are, but Minsk is in Belarusia.
Belarusia.
Yeah, and there's been some, there's been some election news in the United States as well. Let's not get into that. I hear a fight. Oh, good. Oh, so they have... Well, their SAMs are protecting themselves against their own, against my missiles. Luckily, they're losing that fight right now. But are we all healed up here? One. Oh, you are not healed. This is so funny. The SAMs are squaring off. So he'll go there and then he'll return. Interesting. Okay, that's an interesting way of doing it. We're obviously going to need a lot of SAMs, just a ton of them. We have 7 more coming still, so that we do have a lot of SAMs coming. Yeah, we're doing well. Alright, I kind of like this game speed too. I don't know if this is too slow for THG, but you probably just said, this is too slow. So, the one thing I don't want to do is put my SAMs too close to a city, because then a nuclear bomb will take out both at the same time. I want to make them choose, if we can. Now, I don't think we have any threats of over-the-top missiles, so this is where it's nice to, once again, take a look at the map. So there's no threats to us from over-the-top. Oh, okay, that's cool. Is he going to be able to get that airbase? That'd be awesome if he did. So really, we're mostly worried about just direct launches, which is unfortunate, because that means we have less time to react, unfortunately. We're probably just going to pile in. I think we're going to put SAMs pretty much everywhere we can.
Research complete.
Please tell me we have research. Yeah, good. I hope that doesn't get destroyed if Mies gets hit, but it looks like it's, yeah, pretty close. Okay, so research, we're now going to anti-ship missiles, which is good. Then I can put anti-ship missiles on my... What are you guys missing? It must be in the queue, right? Yeah. 3 more fighters? Wait, it says you need 4. Oh, I see. We keep losing fighters. Okay, look it. Don't auto-engage. I mean, I would like them to, ideally, but not when we're this close. The other air bases will have to be positioned a little further back. I feel like we're going to need more air bases, and I'm not sure we're going to go ICBMs. I think we're going to go pure air. Eventually. So, let's get those missiles up. Missile defenses. More SAMs. Always more SAMs. And I think we're going to start tier 2. Never too late for tier 2. So don't launch fighters. Yep, got it. And you can see that there's a lot more out there, but just not ones we can see. And we will be able to see them as soon as we have better radar. So we'll invest in long wave radar. And that should solve our problem. Come on, find the sweet spot. It's close enough. Pacific is building SSBNs. Okay, well, I'm glad we have this patrol now. Maybe I'll make this a 2-man patrol. So let's detach you. Just cancel your orders. Let's have you patrol over here, because a 2-man patrol, I'm going to need more radar, by the way. And you can shift click to add it to the head of the thing. I'm actually going to shift click this one. Let's get this radar up right away, because we do need some radars. In fact, I think I'm going to shift click another one. We're going to need radar just to see where they're putting their stuff. Now, Athens is like totally boned. I don't think there's any way I can save it. There's not even an island I can put this on. We'll do our best, but this is it's not looking good, which we already kind of knew. Okay, so let's put this radar. This will actually be really good once I think that we have the higher... I don't want to put it so close because I actually want AA stuff there. So it's kind of a balancing game. Yeah. I want... I'm going to put it like right here. Hopefully that will give me good visibility without blocking AA positions. And then, yeah, we had... I think we had a radar up here and it was destroyed, so we're going to want another one. Yeah. Any... Oh, God. Enemy missile detected. Where? I hope we're ready. I think they're coming in. New technology. Okay, so by the way, how are we doing? Oh my god, we're almost out of technology. We must research more technology. So, I know I want stealth technology. Advanced air-to-air missiles. I know that seems important. Advanced air... What is this? ABM. What is ABM? SAM complexes... Anti-ballistic missile? Oh wait, that's sounds really good. So ABM. Sounds like it's a remainder versus straight, but over time ballistic. Yep, okay, that we need this. We need it. We need that like desperately. Because that's why I'm building my SAM specifically to destroy missiles. If they don't have the ability to destroy missiles, something went horribly wrong. Okay, now we also need a means of destroying this, so what can we use to destroy that? These land bases. Mobile SAM? No, I need missiles. I need surface-to-surface missiles. So I think what we're going to have to use is aircraft? Or if I can get destroyers close enough. I don't think I can get destroyers close enough. Maybe. You know, I might even cancel your orders and just put these guys... I want them to support each other, but... Put you just all the way over there. And yeah, well, okay. The next thing we need after that is better long-wave radar, which I keep forgetting. What is... Oh, man, we're building one of the aircraft. One of the air bases. That's going to take a long time. Now, how vulnerable are we from the underbelly? It's, again, useful just to look at the world map to kind of see this. Looks like everything has to go through this layer. No, that's not true. Sevilla's kind of exposed. Where are these missiles? I assume that these missiles are here. Oh, we actually can't make it through. Okay, so let me detach you as well. And get you to come over here. Guard this guy. Just gotta have these guys patrol back and forth. Wait, can we go in here? Oh my gosh, heck yeah. Someone just patrol back and forth here, just taking out anything we can. So destroyers, they've worked extremely well for us so far. We have ASMs now, but we can start... I mean, this is gonna be hard. How do we take out these SAMs? We're gonna need, I think, short-range launched missiles. Which I've never needed before, but of course I haven't played Europe before. Europe seems to be a particularly special place. We're just so close to the enemy. Okay, the missile silo right here. Okay, that's what we need to take out. Can we get close enough? I think we can if we get... Well, okay, we're gonna need more destroyers. Look at this guy. This guy's just sitting here. No, get in here. Just leave these guys to their very, very slow... You know what? Actually, this is... We're not gonna do this. You're gonna cancel your orders. We're gonna have this guy go on patrol opposite direction, so pretty much the same thing though. Okay, good. So now we have a little bit more coverage of that area. Hopefully when we get... Yeah, there it is. The second destroyer is going in. Our SAMs are improving. I'm happy. I'm feeling a little bit better. Just to make sure we have some stuff queued up, I want as many SAMs as humanly possible. You seeing that? Oh lord, I think we're gonna have a hard time. At least we know that this area is all clear. Missiles detected. I don't know if this is... Where are these missiles from? Pause when more enemy missiles... No, I don't want to pause. I just want to know where they're coming from, but I assume this is it.
Research complete.
Oh yes, we got one. And we got research complete. Okay, so let's get the next thing lined up. And I want advanced long wave radar. Let's shift click this to the queue. And 65, man, I feel like we need to push it even more, but... Woo! What a fun little episode this is so far. ICBM! Very satisfying game. Look at the front. It's just a wave of SAMs. I mean, it's not too surprising. I'd expect any human player to do the same. 3 more minutes and we get another airbase. Interestingly, if I put this airbase down, it's probably going to start immediately launching. Ugh, you know what we need as well? Shit. Okay, I think I'm going to have to move up on this. Because I also want, besides long wave radar, I want over the horizon radar to be able to detect when missiles are coming. Because otherwise only shortwave radar will detect missiles. And that's not good. But so far nobody's died. Let me ask. give me a good heads up. I have no plans. Next 10 men. Yeah, I think that's accurate. I don't have nukes. I don't even think I'll have... Yeah, I will have an airbase, but I won't have an airbase. Well, this is your seconds. These seconds are going faster than normal seconds. Yeah, okay. So now the tricky thing is going to be to put this and then also not immediately get it blown up. Okay, don't auto-engage. Now, do we want to send out a patrol just to see how bad things are over here? Yes. Okay. Look at that! We got a missile silo! Awesome! What happened here? Why is there... I wonder what this is for. So I thought that cursor meant they were missing somebody. And this one is. Okay, so replenish. We are... I mean, just shift-click this one. Just get it to the front. I don't want to see that notification any longer. Yeah, this is great. We're actually taking out one of their missile silos. Good riddance. Man, we just need a lot. We need a lot of those SAMs.
Air wings replenish.
Awesome. Finally. Okay, so that is not what that yellow reminder is about. Current order is none. That's fine. And these missile silos, usually you have to drop a nuke on them. And that's why I like these nuclear bombs, the first ones. You can destroy a nuclear silo with them. Doesn't take, you know, this garbage situation. Now, the interesting thing to me is, what the hell is the West Asia, so Middle East, as I would call them, what the hell are they doing? I wonder if I should be sending a force around the Horn. This is Cape Horn, right? Good Hope? Cape Horn? I don't know why I get them confused. Well, I know why, because I don't... like, I don't ever bother to look up their name every time I'm confused. I just continue to sit confused. Maybe not the best strategy. Anyway, it's fine. So, this is great. I think we're in good position, though. We set ourselves up well. The only thing we don't have right now, despite the fact that THG's called me being offensive-minded, the only thing we don't have set up is, you know, an offense. Let's see how he's doing. Oh yeah, he has Over the Horizon radar. That's pretty cool. He's setting up his SAM. So he's Forsaken Anchorage. Anchorage is just gonna be dead. Now I expected that we're gonna try to do this all in one sitting, which is madness. It's probably 2.5 hours. We might even need to crank it up to speed 3 or something when things slow down. Let's see. Probably gotta call this video to a close here at some point. Got it. Yeah, this will be in range if we go into... I mean, this is going to be a tough area to go to, but we have sea dominance. Should we not? I think we're going to do it. Let's get a few destroyers. I don't think we even need that last air base, but yeah, we'll get it. Maybe put it right here. Do we want it more in the middle? No, I think a lot of the stuff we're going to target is... Oh, yeah. Yeah, that is... It's going to need to be a big force if we send it, so it better be a lot of destroyers. In fact, you know what? I'm going to take that back. I think we're better off at this point just starting to prepare defenses. And really what we're waiting for is better radar. Okay, so we're doing an airbase and then more SAM sites, and that makes sense to me. We don't need anything more here. Yeah. Production efficiency is still slow. I might want to ask THG if he wants to speed up the timer. Like, things have settled down a bit for me. We have these guys on patrol. And we can't get to the things. You know, we see some stuff, but we can't get to it yet. Anti-ship missile. Yes, we don't need anti-ship missiles. We don't want bombs, per se. Well, maybe we do. Oh wow, cool, he went with SSPNs. That's awesome. Oh, this is really cool. He's preparing some submarine launched submarine launched ballistic missiles. Well, we have at least our frontline defense up. I'm a little worried for the frontline cities, Minsk, Kiev, Odessa, Bucharest, even. Athens for sure. I mean, we almost don't hold out hope for Athens, unfortunately. Yeah, what would we want after that? Yeah, you know what? I guess we could go with more destroyers after we build those, but it shows you why science is just so much more important, it seems like, in the beginning. Because we gotta get... Now, we have to start thinking about, and why not do it right now, we gotta start thinking about what we're gonna research after long-wave radar. What kind of nukes, what's the nuclear option we want to employ? So THG has gone with his SSBNs. We could do intercontinental missiles, but I think our best bet might be air-launched medium-range ballistic missiles. These will allow us to launch, we're going to use our Air Force to launch ballistic missiles. And it allows them to launch from some distance, so it's a little bit less vulnerable to SAMs. Although missile vehicles also seems like a great idea, because we want missiles... I actually don't even want... Yeah. I want medium-range ballistic missiles just to start taking out these enemy SAMs. Just build a ton of them. Heavy rock... Oh my god, heavy rockets. That's insane. I don't even really want ICBMs, because we're close enough we don't need those. I think we'll go with air-launched... MRBMs, because I think we're already investing in the approach. Intelligence, our spies have stolen the technology silent engines. What?
Research complete.
Bees, can you focus on China and the Eastern Asian theater? I'm teching into medium range ballistic missiles, so won't have range for Eastern Asia. Okay, good. And actually, I'm going to pause right here and we'll call this video to a close. Oh, we got another airbase. I'll put that in the beginning of the next episode. So let me just pause real fast and bring this episode to a close. Thanks so much for watching. Okay, we'll go a little bit longer. Thanks so much for watching this one. And if you wouldn't mind, since this is the first video in the series, and make sure you do this on THGs as well, go press the like button. Just for the first video in the series, it's the only time I mention it, but it does help get this visibility up on YouTube, so I greatly appreciate that. And we'll catch you back for episode 2, which will probably be up very shortly. I don't know what the schedule of the release for these will be, but at the... Oh, wow. We definitely just researched long-wave radar. Anyway, I'll catch you back for episode 2. Until then, stay safe and take care. Boop.